simple strings. What will be the output? See, here we have a character array, and since this is a string or character array, and we are trying to print C0. What happens when we declare something like this? A will be stored here and /0 will be stored here because there are two places, 1 and 2. So when you print C0, A will be printed, and when you print C, because C is pointing to A, the name of the array is by itself the address. When you print the percent in the form of %, A will be printed. So in both the cases, A will be printed. In this get organized learn C, we have a character array. When you print this %s2, and this is %s. So we start with this is 0, this is 1, and this is 2. We are expecting to start with 2, and then all string after this T will be printed. From here to here, it will be printed. Now we have this %s. So all will be printed, there is no problem, s is like this only, all will be printed, string, %s, even if you print the s or the address of s, means you are pointing to this location and trying to say whatever is being pointed by s is printed. So again this get organized learn C will be printed, and when you specifically want some element from here, this is second element, so this T will be printed. We have char array, no two viruses work similarly, and this question is about when you reach up till si not equal to /0, just make it just /0, then si, from starting to this /0 we want to print everything, so this si is going to print the n, again s plus i, value at s plus i will again give you n for the first time when I is 0. This also gives you the same one, this also gives you the same one. So all these four are going to give you the same result, that is n. When it runs again, it will give you O. See, n. This n is for this n, this n is for this, this n has come from here, and because of this, this has come. Similarly for next one. This is again a character pointer, or you can say character array, not pointer but array, because we have pointer here. Now we have taken an array, character array, and we want to print this T, but we see here that T is not being used from this point to this point. So T will give you a garbage string. This will be a garbage string. Here also we have S as Mumba Devi. You want to print T, but whatever you do here, there is no T involved. See, no assignment, no operation for T. So again, a garbage string will be printed. Point out the errors, if any, in the following programs. ARR, ABCD needs to be printed. This is ARRI. There is no error in this program. ABCD will be printed. We have rhombus, 8 places. 0 to 7 you want to go, and you want to print ARR. So every time you print, only value at ARR, that is R, will be printed 8 times. 1, 2, 3, 0 to 7. So 8. 8 times R will be printed. 8 times. Why? Because this ARR plus you are doing, you are trying to go from R to H. But this ARR plus is outside this for loop. If you want really to print rhombus, you have to give a brace here and end the brace here. Answer the following. A is a string while this A is a character. This is correct, and we have to fill in the blank. So this is a string, this is a character. A string is terminated by a null character, while which is written as /0. The array character, this name, it consists of maximum of 9 characters exactly, because the last one has to be 9 characters, and then /0 has to be the last one. So it makes it 9 plus 1 10. This is 1. The array element are always stored in contiguous memory location. This is true with every array. Yes, this is true. Which is more appropriate for reading a multi-word string? Getters is the best one. Getters. Observe the purpose of functions. Let us see there. And write your own function. String length, string upper, which should imitate the standard library functions. So as you see here, we have to write a program for string cat, means adding to string, concatenation, comparing two string, making the string to uppercase and lowercase. So we start with stdio.h, conio.h, and we have static char. We have given this str1 as the first one, str2 as the second one, hyphen hassles and hyphen hoopla. Now this x str upr is to make this as upper. So this function we are going to make just now, but this string when it is passed, it will make it in uppercase. Similarly, when you pass str1 to x str lwr lower, it will make it lower. When you say x str cmp, it will compare these two, and there will be a comparison of strings. When you want to concatenate str1 and str2, they will be concatenated and it will be shown in str1. Let us see these one by one, the code of the upper. Upper means it has to be from capital A to capital Z. So we start with the string, means from the first character till the end, means /0. And if this is greater than or equal to 97 and it is less than or equal to 122, that means 97 to 122. If at all we find it, that means they are lowercase. A to Z means they are lowercase. A has ASCII number 97, Z has ASCII number 122. So if it is the case, we have to subtract the value at S, means the ASCII value, subtract 32, so that we can take it to the level where it can be made upper. Means we have to subtract it. And 97 minus 32 is 65, which is actually the equivalent, which is the actually ASCII value of capital A, and likewise. Same logic goes for lower. We'll check for 65 to 90 in between all the strings. If they are 65 to 90, we have to add 32. We have to take it to small a, right? And that small a is 97, and that 65 plus 32 is 97. And likewise, how about comparing? When we want to compare, we say if the value at S equal to value of T, then we say, and see, this is one string, this is another string. We want to compare each element, and if the elements are okay, they are fine, means they are equal, we just go on and on till we reach /0 of both the ends. If we reach S, they are equal, and we reach end, we just return 0 and we say S++ T++. Otherwise, if they are not equal, so you encounter say X and P, so the difference of these two ASCII values has to be returned. So this is value at S minus value of T, that is the ASCII value difference will be returned. How about X str cat, string cat? We have S1 and S2 will pass. So we have to concatenate. One is this string. We have to concatenate the other string, add this string. So we'll take S1, add the length of this S1 with this one. That means we have to start from the first string. First we have to come to the end of the string. That going to first end of the first string will be possible if we add the string length with the S1, because S1 is pointing to the first location. So this string length has to be added to the first location, so that you are pointing now to the next string. And till the time this S2 is not equal to /0, that means this one, we have to assign S1 to S2, means S2 value to S1, increment S1, increment S2. When it is done, when we have enough, well, S2 has come, the last value has to be put as /0. We have to end by ourselves. This program uses certain functions. We have to observe the sample run of this program, and we have to write down the code of this user defined function. So we have to write the code for x left, x right, x substring. So when we see the first one, we have a character array, that is a string, or you can say a sentence. And we have taken new mess as one more character array. This is x left. X left means we have taken mess, this one, and from this we want from first to sixth element, it should be placed in new mess. So when you print a new mess here, you get do not. See, this is 1, 2, 3 space. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So do not will be printed. Similarly, for x right, we start with the last one. And we take 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So TED BP will be shown. Okay. Now the last one, which is a substring, we go to 8th position and we take out 5 characters from there. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We are counting the spaces also. So now B is the pointer and we take 5 elements or 5 characters. So B, L, A, M, E will be taken and this will be printed. I hope you got the idea. Now we'll write the definition of these functions. So we'll write a proper program. Let us change the values also. This is a program. We included the proper files. This is a character array. We have made it as static. And this again, which is the, you can say, an intermediary part, which we are going to take the content from here, put it here and print it. X left, X right, X as substring. So this will take 6 values from the beginning and print. It will take the 8 value from the end. And this will go to 8th position and print 8 value from that position, substring. So this is X left. We have passed the string mess and new mess. New mess is empty in this case also, and the coming case also. So we start from 0 and till n, because we have to take n string and n characters, and each of the value at s has to be given to t, and we have to increment s and t, and this goes on and on for the n steps. And lastly, this target, or you can say the new mess, when it is filled with the element of s, n element of s from the beginning, we just give /0 at the end. When we say x right, that means we have to go to the end first, and then we have to go to the end and then extract the value. So how to reach to the end? We have to reach here. For that, we take s, we take the string length of s, we add them, and then we subtract n from there. I hope you got the idea. Then we have came here, and now that is this position we have come. S plus string length, all, then we subtracted n, so we have come here. And now from this point we have to take n values. So how? Again, we have to go from 0 to n. We start from this position because we have already reached to this position and we wanted n characters from here. So this s is assigned to t, s plus plus t plus plus, this code lies here. This is reading for the first, from the first location. This is reading from the location from where we can extract n. So this is the code for reaching at this point, and again last we have to put /0. This is a code for x substring. For that, first we have to reach at some point and then take out some string from here. So how we are going to use it? We'll use the same logic. We'll take s and t. This is the actual character string, this is the new mess, this is position and n. So we have to add s with position, we have to reach here, this point, and then minus 1, because always the array starts from 0, that is why we have to subtract 1. Now 0 to n we go, from this point to n, and again same code, we assign each value to t, we increment s and t and put /0 at the end of the t, that is the new mess, and we can print it. Write a program that will print out all the rotation of the string typed into it. For example, the rotation of the word space are this. So these are the all possibilities. I can write space as this, spaces, ASP, SESPA, whatever. All these possibilities are to be given. So we write a program to print all the rotation of a string. This is stdio, conio we have added. We have initialized a character, not initialized, but declared a character array and a character or a pointer pointer, character pointer. We asked the user to enter the string. This string will be taken here. We have to find the length of the string. That is, this is how. This is length of 5. If somebody writes, say, hello, yeah, hell. So this is 4. Length is 4. So that is how we need to find out the length. Now, from this point to this point, we every time whenever I goes here, we take the address of this. Say someone has given HELL. So every time this H, first time H has come, so we have to start from here. And then the next one, J equal to 1, till the string length N, till the string length from here, we print the value at S and we increment S. So ELL, right? And every time we have to, if we reach to the slash 0, then we say S equal to STR. Now this str, which is this value, is reassigned to S. Now S will be pointing here. I hope you got the idea. First it was pointing here. Then we printed ELL. Next time we came here. And now we started from ELH. Next time we come here, LLH. So all these combinations are being printed and we say slash n in the last, so that we want each combination to come in the new line. Write a program that replaces two or more consecutive blanks in a string by a single blank. For example, if the input is like this, we have blanks here. Number of blanks are there. We want these blanks, all these blanks have to be converted into one blank. So what will we do? We have to replace more than one blank with a single blank. We start with a character array. Then we say some new mess, because once these blanks are converted to one blank, we have to put it in some character and we'll show this new mess. We'll have two character pointers, clear screen, and now we are assigning this M mess to S and new mess to T. Now S will be pointing here and an empty, this is an empty array. Now T will be pointing here. S is pointing here, T is pointing into the empty array. We take the length of S now, this total length. Then what we do, we start with 0 till L minus 1 and we check whether we have a blank or not. If we again go on. If we have a blank, then what we will do, we will say again, we will check for the next one to be blank. If these blanks are being checked, we assign the value of S to T, because this shows that it can be more than one blank. So first blank, if this is blank, then again blank, how many blanks are there depending upon the case, and when it is not blank, if it is blank, it will not go inside this, we just increment it, it will again go there. If it is again blank, then again it will not go inside this, it will again increment S. But once this is not a blank, then we go and we say, if it is not a blank, then we just put one blank and then we transfer the value S to T to the new array. Then we increment T plus plus. If this is the case, blank, it is okay. Otherwise, because this code is specially, if it is not blank, then we are taking the value of S to T. This is when no blank is there. Well, this is when multiple blanks are there. And finally, in the new mess or the empty array, when all these are filled, we end it with the slash 0. So this is the original statement. This is the statement without the blanks. Two-dimensional array of pointers to string. How many bytes in memory will be occupied by the following array of pointers to string? How many bytes would be required to store the same string if they are stored in a two-dimensional character array? Two-dimensional character array, let us start with that. Two-dimensional character array means we have to write this char mess like this. Okay. So what will be the first value? The first value will be like this. First value will be, we start with H, right? This is H, and this H will be, these are how many rows? 1, 2, 3 and 4. So, this will be 4, there will be 4 rows and I will take the longest string. This we have to, this much space we have to assign for each one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 and slash 0, 17. So, 4 into 17. 4 into 17 is 8, 1 the 4, 68. Okay, 68. So, for 2 dimensional character array, we have to have 68 bytes. How about this? If you as I computed this 17, and if you take array of pointers, only 58 bytes will be taken. If you just the way I counted these characters, you have to count and add these. 58 bytes will be there. Can an array of pointer to string be used to collect string from the keyboard? If not, why not? No, the answer is no, because when we use array of pointer, it is necessary to initialize them at the time of declaration. So the storage class will automatically become static. Write an array to count the number of e in the following array of pointer to string. So we have a character pointer. And we have how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6. So this, they are basically 6 rows. And what we will do, we will take one by one line and try to count the value of number of e's. So we are calculating the number of e's in an array of pointer to string. We have stdio conio.h. So we have a static char star s. This is a character array. Basically, this is an array of pointers. Now we have a star p also. We have taken one more character pointer. We have a count also. So what we are doing here is we are starting from 0 going up to 6 means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 6 rows are there. And every time we are assigning si to p. Means every time p will be pointing here, next time p will be pointing here, every time we are taking the one of them. So while star p, while it is not null, we print the value of whatever value comes, because we are incrementing it also. So value at p will be printed, but if this p is equal to e, the value at p is equal to e, we are just incrementing the count, because count we have taken as 0. This goes for second, when this for loop runs again, we'll go to this line, this line, this line, this goes again and again. And this give you finally the count. When you come out of this loop, the count will be printed, these are the number of e's. Write a program to reverse the string stored in the following array of pointers to string. So we have to reverse the array. We have to write a function xstrrev, string reverse. We have to pass a string which should reverse the content of one string. So, one string, second string, third string, like this. Call this statement for reversing each string in s. So, each string we are going to send and then each string will be reversed. So, how to reverse string stored in array of pointers? Conio stdio we have included. And this is this character point, the array of pointers, which is character, and we start with all these in initialization, and from 0 to 2 we want first this is 0 1 2, so all these three arrays has to be taken, or strings have to be taken, and this function we have to pass, means si, this has to be passed first, then 1 will come, then 2 will come. So first this will be passed, this will be passed, this will be passed, and then we print si every time after reversing. So let us see how this function is going to work. We are passing the string, we are initializing some variables here. Now we go to the string length. Every time a string comes, we compute the length. Then this is the length of the string. This is ss. What is this ss? Which is the initial value. And we say tt is from there. TT is this SS plus the length of the string minus 1, because we know that the string also array goes from 0 to L minus 1. That is why we have subtracted 1. Now from 1 to L minus L by 2, what we are trying to do here is, this is our whole string. We have a pointer here, we have a pointer here. See, we have a pointer which is pointing to the S, which is SS. This is pointer SS. But by this line, what we have done, about by these two lines, we have taken a TT which is pointing to this end. And we go up to L by 2 and take each value from here, take each value from here corresponding, and we swap them. See, we have taken SS to temp, means SS to temp. Now TT to S, and then this temporary has to be transferred here. So we are essentially exchanging or swapping the values. We increment SS, we go from SS, we have to increment, and we decrement the TT also. So every time we go till this time we reach, we have swapped the values. So when we print it, we will see the reverse of string will be there.